Hi, it's Handy Andy Tech Tips here, and today I'm going to give you three more ways to fix this incredibly annoying error. One or more network protocols are missing on this computer. Now, this error also manifests itself as Windows sockets registry entries required for network connectivity are missing. So let's look at the first solution. This is perhaps the easiest of the three, and it is resetting Winsock. Sounds complicated, but it's actually really simple. So firstly, right-click on your start menu. And then click on Command Prompt with admin after it in little brackets. If you see a dialog like this saying that you need to give permission, then just click yes. Alright, so now you're in the command prompt and here's what you need to type. Net sh space winsock space reset. And then press enter. If everything went well, then you should see a message like this, saying that you've successfully reset the Winsock catalog. Then all you need to do is reboot your computer and everything should be fine. But what if it's not? Well, then you'll need my second fix, installing new drivers for your network card. Now, this works because drivers are notorious for getting corrupted, and there's often heaps of compatibility issues as well, especially if you've just upgraded operating system. So just like with the previous tip, you need to right-click on your start menu, and then click on Device Manager. A window should open showing all of your installed hardware. You want to look underneath network adapters. See how it's expanded on my system? Well, if it's not, then you just need to click on the little triangle there. So now you need to try and find which network adapter you're actually connecting to the internet with. In my case, it's the Realtek family controller. And now it's time to find some drivers. Even though I'm going to show you how to do it for a Realtek controller, you can apply virtually the same steps to any network card. So go to another computer, one which actually does have internet access, and then go to Google. All you need to type in is the model of the controller, so I'm going to type in Realtek GBE family controller, and then follow that by driver. Now, I'll click on the first result here because it goes to the manufacturer's website, which is always the best place to get drivers. And then, whoa, this looks complicated, this big table here. But all I need to do is click on the download for Windows 10, which is the operating system that I'm running. So it'll start downloading a zip file down the bottom here. And once it's finished, just transfer the file to a USB stick and insert it into the computer, which is having problems connecting. Then just go inside the zip file, go inside this folder inside the zip file, double click on setup.exe, which is down here a little bit, here it is, and then just follow the steps and you should be done. But what if, after all of that work, you still can't connect to the internet? How frustrating, hey? Well, if that's the case, then I've got one more tip for you. Yes, it's tip three, and it is disable NetBIOS. Now, what in the world is NetBIOS? Well, all you really need to know about it is that it's really old. It dates back to the 1980s, and in all honesty, you don't really need it much anymore. So here's how you can get rid of it. Simply right-click on the start menu and click Control Panel. Then go into the Network and Sharing Center. Click on the little Change Adapter Settings link, this one here, and then find your network adapter. Now, if you did all the earlier steps, then you'll already know what it is. So right-click on it and then go to Properties. Now, see this section here? You need to find Internet Protocol version 4 in this list. And then click on it and click the Properties button down below. Then in this new dialog which opens, just click the Advanced button. Now in yet another new dialog, we're getting pretty deep into the settings here, just click on the Wins tab. And look at that, we've found the settings for NetBIOS. And I'm betting that you know which one to click. Just click on Disable NetBIOS over TCP/IP and then click the OK button. Then just reboot your computer and I'm really hoping that everything will be fine. Now, believe it or not, if the tips in this video didn't help you, then I've actually got another one on this very topic. So please click the screen now if you want to see that video. But anyway, I'm Handy Andy and thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe to my channel if you want more tech how-tos.